Today I'm going to go over the key differences between MD and DO medical school admissions. MD versus DO medical school debate is one that never seems to end. In doing online research, you might read things like, the degrees are practically the same, or as long as you're a doctor, that's all that matters, and so on. While advising students for both MD and DO admissions over the past 15 years, I've heard all sorts of questions from, is it easier to get a DO than an MD? To how will an MD versus DO degree affect my career options or my salary? But what I found is that what most folks really want to know is which one's better. I'm Dr. Chirag Shamasyan, medical school admissions expert and founder of Shamasyan Academic Consulting. In this video, we'll talk about differences in MD versus DO medical school admissions and go over important considerations so you can decide which path is best for you. What's the difference between an MD and a DO? MD stands for Doctor of Medicine and is the degree people most commonly recognize as the doctor degree. MDs attend medical schools accredited by the Liaison Committee on Medical Education, or LCME, and train in allopathic medicine, which relies on medication or surgical intervention to treat disease. DO stands for Doctor of Osteopathic Medicine. According to the American Osteopathic Association, osteopathic medicine is a distinct branch of medicine in the US, which emphasizes the interrelated unity of all systems in the body, each working with the other to heal in times of illness. Many osteopathic programs emphasize a more holistic treatment approach, meaning they aim to treat the patient as a whole person and not just a set of symptoms. For example, holistic physicians may recommend certain lifestyle changes when patients seek treatment for, say, a headache, instead of just writing a prescription. However, it's important to note that DO physicians can write prescriptions. They can also perform surgery, deliver babies, and basically do all the same things an MD does. Conversely, there are also many MDs that treat their patients using a holistic approach. The key difference is in the treatment philosophies they're exposed to as medical students. Perhaps you haven't heard of DOs before, but that doesn't mean that they're any less qualified to practice medicine. The reason why DOs aren't as commonly recognized as MDs is because there are fewer DO schools in the United States. As a result, fewer than 10% of actively licensed physicians in the United States are DOs. But this number continues to increase every year. What's the difference between an MD and DO education? The curricula for MD and DO schools are virtually the same, and the programs are similar in structure, with the first 2 years dedicated to classroom-based learning, and the third and fourth year spent doing clinical rotations, shadowing physicians, and gaining hands-on experience. The main difference is DO students must complete 200 hours of osteopathic manipulative treatment, or OMT training. OMT is a set of techniques whereby the clinician moves a patient's muscles and joints to diagnose, treat, and prevent illness or injury. Not all DOs elect to use OMT techniques in their medical practice, but regardless, must learn them in medical school. Is it easier to get a DO versus an MD? MD and DO programs require applicants to complete the same courses and gain the same extracurricular experiences prior to applying. However, MD schools tend to have higher GPA and MCAT score averages for admitted students. For the 2018 to 2019 application cycle, the average MCAT and GPA for students entering US MD programs were 511.2 and 3.72 respectively. For students matriculating into DO programs, the average MCAT was 503.8 and the average GPA a 3.54. How a DO versus MD degree will impact your residency training. To become a licensed physician, you'll need to complete residency training in your chosen specialty. MD students can match only to residencies accredited by the Accreditation Council for Graduate Medical Education, ACGME, whereas DO students can match to residencies accredited by ACGME or the AOA. However, those accreditation councils will merge after June 30, 2020, allowing MD and DO students to apply to any residency program. Some ACGME accredited residencies require that students pass USMLE to be considered for their program. This means that DO students, who usually take Comlex only, must take the USMLE as well if they want to apply to these programs. Although there's been a major push by groups like the American Medical Association to recognize the Comlex and USMLE as equal for residency admissions, there are no plans to implement any changes to licensing exam requirements post-merger. A quick note on prestige. Many students prefer to attend MD over DO programs because of differences in perceived prestige. However, note that once part of the medical community, MD and DO physicians can practice in the same ways. Are there differences in DO versus MD salary? When looking at raw data, we see that MD physicians earn higher incomes on average than DO physicians. However, this is simply because MD physicians tend to specialize and practice in urban areas. When factors like specialty, position, years of experience, and location are the same, MD and DO earnings are equal. So MD versus DO, which is better? If you've made it this far, you won't be surprised to hear that one degree is not inherently better than the other. Both MD and DO physicians can be licensed to practice medicine in all 50 states and receive the same extensive training to ensure they're capable of delivering high-quality care to patients. So which program should you apply to? The answer to this question depends on three factors: preferred training modality, career goals, and your stats, so your GPA and your MCAT score. If the osteopathic training philosophy to treating the whole person appeals to you and you're interested in learning osteopathic manipulative treatment techniques, DO programs could be a great option for you. While doing clinical rotations during your third and fourth years of medical school, you might find yourself drawn to a specialty you previously thought you wouldn't enjoy. If you anticipate pursuing a competitive specialty like plastic surgery or dermatology, you'll be more likely to match into these programs if you attend an MD school. But if you're certain that you want a career in primary care, you'll want to base your decision on your preferred training modality, since both MD and DO programs can prepare you well for primary care specialties. If your stats are lower than MD program averages, but you're still interested in pursuing a medical career, DO programs will give you a chance to make this dream a reality. This doesn't mean that you should only apply to MD programs or only DO programs. In fact, many students apply to a mix of programs, recognizing the unique value of each treatment approach. So if you're on the fence between DO and MD programs, do your research and think carefully about the type of physician you want to be. Above all, be sure to communicate your fit with the schools you're applying to and demonstrate that you have the potential to be a great doctor. If you found this video helpful, give it a thumbs up and subscribe so you don't miss out on new videos. And if you'd like to learn more about the med school admissions process, including a whole section on how to develop a school list that maximizes your admissions odds, click the link in the description to get my free comprehensive guide, How to Get into Medical School. The strategies in the guide are the same ones our team uses to routinely help students get into schools like Johns Hopkins, Mayo, and UCSF. All right, thanks for watching. See you next time.